structure that's going to make the difference in this one, folks. These superstars can act all nonchalant all they want, but when you see that structure and the door slams behind you, I don't care who you are, you shudder inside.
No argument there, Corey. That's why there have been so few WWE superstars who have ever had the guts to step inside the structure for a Hell in a Cell match.
The thing that makes this so much more insidious than a simple cage match is there's no escape. The door is padlocked, and the only way out is by pinfall or submission.
Or by stretcher, maybe. There's always that.
Way to get out hard there.
And responds with a counter of their own.
Sent crashing to the floor.
Now on the outside, right by those cell walls. And he has an answer for Rikishi.
Oh, chin-breaking uppercut.
It is almost impossible to prepare for Hell on Earth, but Corey, what is the key to coming out on top in this one?
You gotta do things you never thought you'd have to do before, that you never wanted to do before, because this is an environment like no other.
The competitors must channel a primitive, barbaric version of themselves.
Oh!
And the wall comes crashing down!
Things are breaking down now. Who built this thing?
This is rather reckless of him, wouldn't you say?
This whole match is reckless.
But necessary.
Oh no, what's this all about?
He's making the climb.
Looks like an act of desperation. A big one. All right, he's at the top now. Oh, look at the knee strikes. Burying knees into the body. We've already seen part of the cell break apart. No time. What more can break apart? Now these athletes are taking their chances in a very perilous position at the top of Hell in a Cell. Laid out with a power slam. Just waiting on bated breath.
We've all seen life-altering moments come from the top of that cell.
Yeah. Lesnar quick to counter.
Catches the punch. Are these superstars even aware of the peril they're in?
I think they have blinders on, Saxton. I don't think they're completely aware of their surroundings. They just have tunnel vision for each other.
Arms trapped. Precision strikes.
Warm up the engine on the ambulance. I got a very bad feeling about where these competitors are going to end up soon.
Oh, that hurt right to the kidney.
Golly.
Oh, target locked into this.
Oh, my gosh. I've seen it all now.
Are you nuts?
I can't remember the last time we've seen devastation like this. What must be going through these superstars' minds?
The sound of this crowd is deafening, and he's asking for more.
He's on top of the cell now.
Why? Why is he on top of the cell?
I think we're about to find out, Corey.
And he has an answer for Rikishi.
Look at this.
Oh, a backbreaker.
Right to the spine.
You could hear the chain link fence buckling with every impact.
Snap suplex.
Knee right to the gut.
For that one. Ooh, slam!
With authority.
We knew this was going to be a vicious match, but these superstars are taking it above anyone's expectations.
Scooped up, here it comes!
Rikishi driver!
she got all of it.
To the arm, terrible. This whole arena is standing, watching these maniacs battle it out 25 feet above the ground. Crank in the head. Rikishi with a bonsai drop.
Brock with the quick wherewithal. Look at him totally vibing with the WWE Universe. Slam. Can that finish the Beast off?
And now in the most dangerous area inside the cell.
And the electricity of this moment is coursing through his veins. Guys, he clearly has no regard for his own well-being.
What gave you the first hit, Myron?
He made it. He made it to the top.
I can't even imagine what he has. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Stop this. Don't do it from up there.
This is too much.
For the love of mankind, he fell right out of the sky.
This is beyond dangerous. This is more than reckless. No one should be up there, let alone performing these maneuvers. Rikishi able to dodge that.
Lesnar cuts him off. Reversal after reversal. These two are ready for each other.
The Crimson Mask now being worn by Rikishi after that.
Why in the world are they doing this? They escaped the dangers of the cell just to fight up to the top where every step could be your last.
Striking at will.
Defends off the attack.
Oh, running FTO plants him.
Nicely done.
Where do these superstars get the idea to do this?
I don't know, but if this is something they dreamt of, I wouldn't want to know what their nightmares look like.
Lesnar moved.
Finds the advantage after a string of counts.
Knee right to the gut. Hell of a mountain, gentlemen, and these poor souls are duking it out at the summit.
Stomping.
Rikishi able to dodge.
Boom, running FTO plants him.
Nicely done.
Solid punch. Cell.
Someone get in there and check on him. There's no way this can continue.
The sound of this crowd is deafening, and he's asking for more.
This isn't the smartest thing to do, antagonizing your opponent instead of attacking him. Making his climb up the cell now.
Why on earth would you do that?
He has summited the cell.
But will the reward be worth the risk?
Oh!
And with every step up there, the amount of fear on these superstars increases.
The top of the cell is like walking through a minefield.
Approaching uncharted territory in this matchup, I would remind you medical staff is on standby for both of these men.
WWE Universe wants tables. Well, they've got tables.
Looks like he has something planned with his table, guys.
I don't want to know.
We've got to acknowledge these fans, a packed arena, and we're hearing every single voice.
It is loud and it is mad in here.
He's been placed in the corner now. Answering back!
Both superstars showing great awareness of their opponent's repertoire.
One after the other. Can't wait.
Lesnar's got this closed up.
It's almost down. One, two,
three. That's the win in a brutal Hell in a Cell match.
Here is your winner, Brock Lesnar.
I can't imagine a world in which they're not proud of that win.
That was a dominating showing where we saw the beast, Brock Lesnar, just annihilate his opponent.
That's what Brock does best.